Hi. Last session, we discussed psychology as a discipline. Today, we will continue exploring furthermore. Let's see. Psychology as a natural science. It has been mentioned earlier that psychology has its roots in philosophy. I feel every subject drives to philosophy, some or other day. Discoveries or knowledge gained by a human being so far is really less when compared to unexplored world or nature. Scientific method of inquiry is not possible every time, so philosophical approach has its own merits in any field. We cannot simply discuss the meaning of philosophy. It cannot fit on words or any language. It's just an expression and will have its own exploration, and truth is unique to every human being. In psychological study, you will understand the person or client on the basis of particular situation, state of mind, and information given to you are communicated at that point of time only. Everything changes once the person leaves the room. So you are not completely analyzing a person's mind, but just doing postmortem to the situation or past. Next, however, modern psychology has developed because of application of scientific method to study psychological phenomenon. Science places a great deal of emphasis on objectivity, which can be obtained if there is consensus on the definition of a concept and how it can be measured. So, as said, it may be difficult to put every thought on paper. Science tries to understand mind in terms of alphabets and numbers. This is what measuring and objectifying mind. Psychology was influenced by Descartes and later on by developments in physics, has grown by following what is called a hypothetico-deductive model. The model suggests that scientific advancement can take place if you have a theory to explain a phenomenon. For example, physicists have what is called a Big Bang theory to explain how the universe came to be formed. Therefore, it is nothing else but a set of statements about how a certain complex phenomenon can be explained with the help of propositions which are interrelated. Based on a theory, scientists deduce or propose a hypothesis that offers a tentative explanation of how a certain phenomenon takes place. The hypothesis then is tested and proved true or false based on empirical data that one has gathered. The theory is revised if data gathered point in a different direction than the one suggested by the hypothesis. Using the above approach, psychologists have developed theories of learning, memory, attention, perception, motivation, and emotion, etc., and have made significant progress. Till date, most of the research in psychology follows this approach. Apart from this, psychologists have also been considerably influenced by the evolutionary approach, which is dominant in biological sciences. This approach has also been used to explain diverse kinds of psychological phenomena such as attachment and aggression, to mention just a few. Let's see this. Psychology was influenced by Descartes. In psychology, Descartes is most known for his concept of dualism, relation between mind and body. After this, the study of mind has taken new level of approach. Just try to understand dualism concept a bit more at your feasibility. Next, I'll introduce you two more words, inductive and deductive. These are two methods of inquiry. Inductive method, which is specific to general or bottom-up logic, and deductive method is general to specific or top-down approach. Differences between deductive and inductive reasoning is that deductive reasoning starts with a statement or hypothesis and then tests to see if it's true through observation, where inductive reasoning starts with observations and move backwards towards generalizations and theories. For example, a mango is sweet and all mangoes in the basket are sweet. So in the other way, as all mangoes are sweet, this one mango is also sweet. Try to work on few more examples, but it's worth spending time on these methods. So, coming to one more topic today is psychology as a social science. We mentioned about that psychology is recognized more as a social science because it studies the behavior of human beings in their socio-cultural context. In simple words, it is society or different cultures around the world. Culture in India is different from America. Eastern tradition versus Western tradition. Humans are not only influenced by their socio-cultural context, they also create them. Psychology, as a social science discipline, focuses on humans as social beings. Consider the following story of Ranjita and Shabnam. Ranjita and Shabnam were in the same class, studying in same school. Although they were in the same class, they were just acquainted with each other and their lives were quite different. Ranjita came from a farmer's family. Her grandparents, parents and elder brother worked on their farm. They lived together in their house in the village. Ranjita was a good athlete and was the best long distance runner in the school. She loved meeting people and making friends. Unlike her, Shabnam lived with her mother in the same village. Her father worked in an office in a town nearby and came home during holidays. Shabnam was a good artist and loved staying home and taking care of her younger brother. She was shy and avoided meeting people. Last year, there was very heavy rain and the river nearby overflowed into the village. Many houses in the low-lying areas were flooded. The villagers got together and organized help and gave shelter to people in distress. Shabnam's house was also flooded and she came to live in Ranjita's house with her mother and brother. Ranjita was happy helping Shabnam's family and making them feel comfortable in their house. When the flood water receded, Ranjita's mother and grandmother helped Shabnam's mother to set up their house. The two families became very close. Ranjita and Shabnam also became very good friends. In this case of Ranjita and Shabnam, both are very different persons. They grew up in different families under complex social and cultural conditions. You can see some regularity in the relationship of their nature, experience, and mental processes with their social and physical environment. But at the same time, there are variations in their behavior and experience which would be difficult to predict using the known psychological principles. One can understand why and how individuals in communities become quite helpful and self-sacrificing in crisis, as was the case with the people in the villages of Ranjita and Shabnam. But even in that case, not every villager was quite equally helpful, and also under similar circumstances, not every community is so forthcoming. In fact, sometimes the opposite is true. People become antisocial under similar circumstances, indulging in looting and exploitation when some crisis occurs. One more example to understand this is in India. Being a home for many religions and languages, we unite at times and take a stand to support each other in times of need. During cyclones, drought, and even this pandemic, people supported Janta Curfew, lockdown, donated groceries to the poor and needy. On the other way, there are some social issues raised in other parts of the world, such as US, between blacks and whites in recent times, where there is a destruction of property and exploitation. Just go through similar examples for better understanding. This shows that psychology deals with human behavior and experience in the context of their society and culture. Thus, psychology is a social science with focus on individuals and communities in relation to these, to their socio-cultural and physical environment. So with this, I end the session for the day. Thank you so much for being part. Just let us know where there are any understanding issues and your queries to respective mail ID. Have a great day.